members of KPFA Apprenticeship Program. Send your listing at least 3 weeks in advance to KPFA Box 51, 1929, Martin Luther King Jr. Way in Berkeley, California 94704, or fax them to 510-848-3812, attention to the community calendar. Tell us if your event is wheelchair accessible. To hear this calendar again, call 510-848-6767, extension 621, or visit us online at www.kpfa.org.
And this is KPFA and KPFB in Berkeley and KFCF in Fresno. The time is now 7 o'clock. And Living Room on Friday, March the 5th at 12 p.m. How to Meet the Scary State of the World. These are the very trademarks of a woman named writer Anne Lamont, who joins Chris Welch noon to 1 on Friday on Living Room. Stay tuned now for Apex Express.
Apex Express, Asian Pacific Expression.
Cultural coverage,
music and calendar,
new visions and voices,
coming to you with an Asian Pacific Islander point of view.
It's time to get on board the Apex Express. Hey, this is Dee here on Apex Express with Curtis on the board. We have a very, very special Asian Pacific Islander program here tonight on Apex Express. The first Thursday of every month, we have Asian American hip hop, API, Hot Topics, Picks, and Events. I am really honored to be a part of this. We are going to be co-presenting with PUSOD, which is a cultural arts space here in Berkeley. And we have the director, program director of PUSOD with us tonight. Maya, why don't you just say hi so people can hear your voice?
What's up, y'all? Thanks for tuning in.
And we're going to have a very special guest, Kiwi, MC, rapper. And he is part of the group, duo, Native Guns. Is that right?
That's right. Native Guns, myself, and Bamboo. I'm an MC myself, and, I'm just real excited to be a part of this program.
I know, because there's not a whole lot of chances people can hear, you know, API hip-hop or API anything, so this is their chance. And I guess I'm going to ask you guys just a question or two, just throw it out. Basically, what's up for tonight, and, anything you want to throw in there before we get into it?
Well, tonight we're going to be talking with Tad Nakamura, who's the writer, director, producer of this documentary film, Yellow Brotherhood, which is going to be screening at the Asian American Film Festival this month. And, of course, we're going to be playing some hip-hop, also on the music end of things. In addition to our featured artists, we're going to be playing a mix of hip-hop by API artists, including groups like the Visionaries, Blue Scholars, the Pacifics, Ink Fatchies from Vallejo, and, of course, Native Guns. And, of course, we have an exclusive interview with none other than Denizen Kane of Chicago-based hip-hop crew Typical Cats.
You know, Maya, I understand Denizen Kane is going to be down at PUSOD tomorrow night, Friday, which is kind of, in a way, an extension of this show. You're going to get a taste of it here live on air tonight and then see these folks live tomorrow night.
Yeah.
Is that right?
Yeah, I actually wanted to talk about this partnership a little bit more. This partnership between PUSOD and Apex was created to actively support community-based homegrown radio shows, arts and cultural spaces, and the artists. Because it's self-evident that we got a lot of talent in our community.
Yep.
And we're also pushing the envelope in music. And our influence has been an exchange between a diverse and broad range of cultures, genres, and mediums, you know what I'm saying? So because of this, along with the fruits of the API movement, we also know that we've gained a lot more tools, whether it be through resources, skills, physical space, or an hour slot on the radio. The essential question is, how do we support one another and make it work for us?
You know, in answer to that, I'm just gonna have y'all take it away now. You know, I'm gonna throw it over to, I think, Kiwi, just to intro this first part of the show.
All right. So again, this is Apex Express, and we're just gonna get into right. We have Denizen Kane tonight, so we're gonna get into one of his joints right now. This one's off the first CD on Galapagos Records that he put out, entitled Tree City Legends. This is Denizen Kane with Early Burn here on Apex Express. 94.1 KPFA, KPFB in Berkeley, KFCF in Fresno.
Get it right this time. the womb around 78. First son and final heir to a throne, charted 7-8. But no man or Romans to give fictional blessing. Only Ronin standing on the battlefield at Mount Vieli, hollering a mighty medicine into the air. A brother who lay slumbering beneath the earth, I'm here to ask him to return, resurrect and reappear. Bruh, I got my fam, I got my shield, I got my spear. I got my 23 years in the grave, the star in there. A song full of terror and a pocket full of tears. I got my ancestors up and waiting to speak. And then in the inhabitants of rhymes and beats. A people without speech meet seeds without feet. A hands to make fists, a fight to make peace. Burn like the bomb in the lungs of the listeners who breathe the broken passion in the midst of our chrome prisoners.
Peace to fallen soldiers, may they sleep and be blessed. Life is worthless without the fire burning in my chest. Peace to fallen soldiers, may they sleep and be blessed. Life is worthless without the fire burning in my chest.
I press my face into the river till it looks like me. Scatter words until the currents of the water can speak. I'll be asked what I've given, so I live as I leave. And gather more into my bone, I know that I can keep. And on an earthy devil that does darken and deceive. Bless the cats that crawled up into heaven and fell asleep. And the mothers who climbed blind when the mountain was steep. And the shepherd of my soul who keeps counting the sheep. Is the author of my being who writes me unique. Who made me denizen, cane upright and all heat. Throw against my fist till I face the white sheet. I come upon Jacob's son to flash on the black street. Story travels on as a song without repeat. A reminder rewinding the forgetful who weep. But what is it remembered or reminded? Kill will find it across the valley for the mountains died in the slide.
Peace to fallen soldiers, may they sleep and be blessed. Life is worthless without the fire burning in my chest. Peace to fallen soldiers, may they sleep and be blessed. Life is worthless without the fire burning in my chest.
Yes, 94.1 KPFA, KPFB in Berkeley, KFCF in Fresno. This is Apex Express, Asian Pacific Islander Radio. And you know what? We're just, you know, we're going to just keep playing some music right now. We're going to get into this quick mix featuring a whole bunch of API artists. This is API Hip Hop right here on KPFA 94.1. Hit me, Curtis!
You are now in tune to Apex.
We started as one, then we drifted, separated as continents that shifted. All the pieces fit. Can't you see the togetherness, missionary Pangea? We started as one, then we drifted, separated as continents that shifted. All the pieces fit. Can't you see the togetherness, missionary Pangea?
It all began together, before we ever ran together, before we ever took a stand together. We understand that whether or not we tether or not for humanity, we must stand to wither the hatred. Separation, it's easier to make than break it. We're breaking stereotypes with the yes, y'all on the mic. Get yourself right. We're not all alike, but fall right into place. Face adversity, appreciate diversity. Nursery to university, pass any degrees. See universally, disperse in the verse commercially or underground. One love bound by culture and sound. Been around the world and no denying. We're all under the same sun, so keep shining.
The plan's so small with all the origins. Whichever one you're in, we get the light pouring in. We pass segregation with unification. Savages invading civilizations. Riddle the nation with belittlement. We lift up without aviation. We're only divided by distance. It's an honor, this is outstanding. An 8-year flight came in for the landing. We spread all over the map. Instead of stripping the culture, we give love back. We started as one, then we drifted, separated as continents that shifted. All the pieces fit. Can't you see the togetherness, visionary Pangea?
Always writing, always revising. shorty feels the pressure on his shoulders as he's lifting it. Wonders why the elders always tell him not to question it. Options at the bottom of the ladder got him desperate, but all he ever wanted was a weapon to protect him with. Riding a 36 through the veins of the beacon. The water is the heart. It's raining when it's beating. The city that I sleep in, I'm dreaming while I'm awake. The miserable escaping, they're too high to ponder fate. But who am I to use the plight to illustrate a rhyme with everything around me that I've never had to live? But I observe the inequalities to serve the people properly. Tell them that the freedom isn't found in private property. Prostitutes are more than just the folks who sell their bodies. See, this applies to those whose souls are a commodity. I can hear the colony calling me back to be the bullet in the belly while they lock, load, and squeeze. Rebel with a pen and our fuck shots and threes. Rewriting what it into what it ought to be. They made a mockery out of the possibility, but under constant revision is the poem that I be. Rebel with a pen and our fuck shots and threes. Rewriting what it is into what it ought to be. I be the MC in the place not to be, but under constant revision is the poem that I be.
Yeah, Chicago, it's like this, y'all. Yeah, Pacifics, propaganda movement. Yeah, wind chill factor. Yeah, the whole yellow text. We're gonna bring it like this. KP, Strike 3, and Norman Rockwell, y'all.
Whatever part of town, that is your stomping ground. Just hold your hands up high and never put them down. You come from out of town, you better hold your ground. We got the golden sound, go ill, we hold it down. The wind that blows around here's enough to knock you down. Rockin' sound all year round, we ought to talk about. We're elevating trains of thought, you know the sound. Chicago, Illinois, boy, you know we hold it down.
City becomes mine while I'm writing this rhyme. Taking the time to reflect on a shot where my people reside in bungalow homes and projects that rise high. A ghetto in the sky lights up the nighttime, where every resident's affected by the skyline. Its silhouette reflects in my eyes, cause they pry wide open, scoping for some hope in the streets, the crossroads where the poor and the privileged meet. It's the land where gangbangers rock me hats cocked straight, defending the block from the venomous cops, where the enemies plot to judge your body, same spot. Culture sacrifice the corporate big shots, for here there's a priceless soul that blows a breeze, putting my soul at ease when I roam these streets. And when the wind chill drops below 0 degrees, shot streets are gonna stay high to Mr. Freeze.
Whatever part of town, that is your common ground. Just hold your hands up high and never put them down. You come from out of town, you better hold your ground. We got the golden sound, go ill, we hold it down. The way that blows around here's enough to knock you down. Rockin' sound all year round, we gotta talk about. We're elevating trains of thought, you know the sound. Chicago, Illinois, boy, you know we hold it down.
Of all the things that have ever made you mad, he is air through your fingers as he brushes against your neck in bittersweet aroma. In fact, your nasal passages that smell so good, it hypnotizes the fluids that provide you to speak fluent. Without reason, he is pleased to help with this disease called stress, giving equal amounts of love we take for granted. Nevertheless, he shares his strength. The workday is retired, and you need to exhale and reach for something higher. He's your soul's choir, singing melodies of peace and tranquility. It's a feeling a person can't keep secretly. He's the calmness of the sea and the neighbor of the sun. His name is Freedom. Freedom.
Free your mind, relax and take your time. Soul search within on whatever you can find. Light shine,
before my body gives up. I live a life of fantasize and my mama don't wait up. Cause I'm battling the beast tonight and the men they made up. I'm drowning, but I just can't get up. Gas before a little quick,
Listen, Christine, young queen from around the block, walking through the neighborhood to the sound of pop. If you seen her off the top, you would say she looked so lovely. But every day she tell herself she was so ugly. Hair butt was too big, nose too flat, skin too dark and lips too fat. All that blush and eyeshadow just to cover the fact. What was hiding under that was her stuck in the trap. Wanted to look like a model in a magazine. Didn't care if Martin Luther King had a dream. All she wanted was a reason for some self-esteem. And to think Christine was only 17. Started seeing white dudes to make her feel special. Started to take the self-hate to another level. Alcohol to weed, weed to cocaine. Whatever it would take so she could feel no pain. It was a cold game, her freedom never came. Pipe to her fat lips, needle to her vein. In one emotion silently she said ready aim. Looked at the mirror and she put the heater to her brain.
I just can't get up. Gasp before we had a quick breath before my body gives up. I'm living like a rat to die, tell my mama don't wait up. Cause I'm battling the beast tonight and the plans ain't made up. I'm drowning, I just can't get up. Gasp before we had a quick breath before my body gives up. I'm living like a rat to die.
Just a boy and he tattooed up. Bald head, brown skin, had an old man gut. He had a old man struck for many years in the hood. His presence by itself had the police shook. Cause he was young, he was brown, he was down with the set. But that ain't really what had the police upset. See, at 16, he was so far up ahead of his grade. He's the hope of the ghetto, he's gonna get us all saved. Straight A student, he was graduating early. Full scholarship to any Cali University. So early Thursday, January 39th came.
Lone gunman on the loose.
And he kinda got the same frame. He went to trial at the age of 16. And the judge deemed him fit as doing adult things. So as they raped him in prison, little boy doing life. Could only escape by wondering what college was like. College was like, college was like.
Yes, yes. Yeah. Apex Express, Asian Pacific Islander Community Radio, 94.1 KPFA, KPFB in Berkeley, KFCF in Fresno. And, you know what? We wanted to talk a little bit more about this programming. So, Maya, why don't you go into that a little bit more?
Sure, sure. First off, I'm really excited. Are you?
I'm
great.
We are running around here, folks. You don't even know.
So, you know, as I was saying, we all need support. And a lot of people, you know, it's hard to ask for support. It's hard to seek how we're going to support one another. So one way is to help maintain all of our spaces, you know, like KPFA, Apex Express here, and Pusaj is just down the street. You know, we're a cultural space having shows all the time. There's no reason we can't support one another. So we want to keep it, our spaces locked. We want to keep it safe. We want to keep it organic, let it breathe and grow where it needs to, and keep it accessible to the communities that we serve. So, you know, based on that, we got this exchange going on here between Pusaj and Apex. You are listening to the premiere, the launch of this fresh new Apex program featuring API Hip Hop. And since we only have an hour on the airwaves and even less time and space to the artists and you listeners, Pusaj and Apex have partnered up to give you Apex Out the Box tomorrow night at Pusaj. It's a live and direct show giving you listeners a chance to experience the artists featured on the show tonight. Tomorrow night, which will be every first Friday of the month at 8 p.m. at Pusaj with your host, Kiwi.
Who?
Kiwi.
Hi.
Who we got lined up for the show?
Well, tomorrow we have this brother by the name of Rupert Estenlao, and he's a spoken word artist as well as group therapy from Vallejo. Actually, they're both from Vallejo. And then, of course, our feature artist, Dennis and Kane.
Yeah, we also got DJ Farah out of Vallejo, too, who will be the selector for the evening.
Cool. Well, let's get a... We did an interview with Dennis. So why don't we get into that real quick? And we're back. Apex Express, Asian Pacific Islander Community Radio, 94.1 KPFA, KPFB in Berkeley, KFCF in Fresno, and we are here with Tad Nakamura, who's the writer, director, producer, etc. of this film, this documentary film entitled Yellow Brotherhood. and it's going to be showing this month at the Asian American Film Festival in San Francisco. Thanks for joining us, man. How you doing?
Cool.
So let's get right into it, man. What's this film about?
Basically, this film's about me and my three friends growing up in Culver City. We started off as a basketball team called Yellow Brotherhood, just like a lot of Japanese Americans playing in the J Leagues and stuff. So just growing up normal, and then right around, I think maybe middle school, started wondering what that name was, because, you know, everyone had names like the Lakers, you know, whatever, and we had Yellow Brotherhood, people tripping off, what's that mean? So we didn't really know even, so I think probably around 13, 14, started learning about it. Actually, the name is from an organization that was started out of the Crenshaw District down here in L.A. in the late 1960s, and it was formed to keep youth off of drugs and out of the streets. And so the legacy of that was a basketball team that we all started when we were about 6 years old. So it's basically just a story that goes over the history of the organization itself and the legacy that me and my friends kind of fell into.
Right. So in the movie, you talk about this group back in the days called the Ministers. Now tell us a little bit about these guys.
Okay, yeah. So I think a lot of people don't know that even before World War II, at least all I know is at least in LA, there's been Asian American gangs, and you know, it wasn't really, it's not like gangsters now, you know, no one was carrying heat, no one was really, you know, killing no one. It was more, I guess what you would think is, you know, those old school motorcycle gangs, maybe some had tattoos, had the pompadours, and they would just throw down kind of parties and stuff. So it wasn't necessarily territorial, it was more as just crews. So one of the, I think it was, there's a whole, actually a whole list of gangs on the west side in the Crenshaw area, because that was actually predominantly majority Japanese American during that time. And we're talking, you know, the 50s and 60s. So the Ministers was one of the gangs around that area.
And tell us what the turning point was for this gang, the Ministers, to form this program called Yellow Brotherhood.
Basically, like a lot of, you know, gangsters, eventually a lot of them either landed up in jail or went to the army or got drafted in the military. So after they all kind of came out, all the OGs were kind of done with it, you know, saw that they weren't really doing anything positive, came back, and then all of a sudden that gang culture actually totally shifted to where it was totally drugs infiltrated the community, you know. And so I think they had the maturity to look back and see that that wasn't really productive for the community. So they actually turned it around and used their kind of status and respect as gangsters in the neighborhood to kind of organize the youth. And because this was also at the time of the early Asian American movement, Black Panther Party was getting going, and, you know, Vietnam War movement, anti-war movement was in full effect. So inspired by that, they kind of started doing political workshops and mainly trying to get them off the drugs, because a lot of them were just basically kind of addicts and hooked on it.
Right. So now tell me, what compelled you, Tad, to do this film?
I think like anyone, you know, at first I really feel like I was just your normal person, didn't have a crazy childhood or whatever. But I was actually took a class when I was a student at UCLA, and each student makes a documentary film. This is the ethno-communications class out of the Asian American Studies Center. So just kind of thinking what I wanted to do, you know, tell my story. But at the same time, I always knew Yellow Brotherhood's history and the fact that no one else knew what the Yellow Brotherhood did, or those who did know about that name, it had a real bad stigma to it. You know, all there was thugs, they were, you know, beating kids up, whatever. And so I wanted to not only put, kind of just give Yellow Brotherhood its own place in Asian American history, but also kind of correct the false stereotypes and false kind of stories that people have heard. So basically I wanted to do that. The first cut of the film that I did was really all historical, and it was pretty much following the history of that organization. But then as it got going, to make it just a little more relevant for people to identify with, I started kind of added my story in.
Now, what would you say is the relevance of documenting stories such as this?
Well, I definitely think, I mean, basically, you know, the society that we live in right now, corporate media is only covering things that I mean, they're getting money to do, usually they're sponsored, so that's why you see a lot of, you know, issues, whether it's in the news or even mainstream media, just that you can't really relate to. So number one, you know, our communities don't get documented. And number two, if we don't do it, no one's going to do it. So basically, that's where I'm coming from in terms of not, you know, we have complaining that we don't get our stories told. Number one, I don't think it's, you know, because if it's done by corporate media, it's going to be done wrong, too. So I think it's going to be very exploitative. It's going to be from definitely from the outsider's view looking in. So I think in terms of documenting ourselves as people of color in this country, we really need to do it from within to get a, you know, kind of honest portrayal of who we are, and basically allow us to tell our own stories.
Uh-huh. Now, say I was some young API dude and I was at this festival and I was trying to decide which of these movies I wanted to see. Why would it be important for me to see Yellow Brotherhood?
I think, you know, especially for youth, there's not too many films out there about youth. And I mean, I'm 25 now, but I still consider myself, you know, coming from a youth perspective. So I think whether it's, you know, just the music in the film, whether it's the pace of the film, and it's short, you know, it's only 18 minutes, so I think a lot of us have short attention spans, so it ain't that long. But I think it is, it's hopefully some people could relate to it, whether it's, you know, if you're in high school and you've had homies that you've grown up with since you were five, or if you have a kind of a piece of history that you necessarily don't feel part of, but then you discovering that you're actually part of that, you know, that does a lot to help shape your identity, who you are now. So I think, you know, if anything, you'll definitely learn a little bit about Asian American history that hasn't been documented. And two, I think the soundtrack bumps too, so it's pretty entertaining to watch.
Tight. So not only is it informative, but it's also very thoughtfully put together from a youth perspective. Now, it's going to be showing at the Asian American Film Festival. Tell us when and where people in the Bay Area can see this.
Okay, so yeah, again, the title of the film is Yellow Brotherhood, and because it's a short film, it's going to be playing with three other short films, and that program itself is called Brotherhood Best, and that's going to be screening on Sunday, March 13th at 7 p.m. at the AMC Kabuki Theater in Japantown, San Francisco. It's 1881 Post Street, and so hopefully you can check that out. Tickets are available online. You can go to www.natanet.org/festival and get tickets online.
And again, that website is natanet.org, natanet.org/festival. So, wait a minute. So, isn't there stuff for high school youth as well?
There's a special high school screening on the following Wednesday. That's the March 16th Wednesday at 1 p.m. And that'll be at the same AMC Kabuki 8 Theater, but that's strictly for high school youth.
Okay.
So especially, I think, if all your teachers out there, educators, I think it's up to the teachers to hook that up so their students, it's a field trip. So if you're an educator and you're kind of interested in bringing your students out to that, you can contact NATA Film Festival staff, and that can email them at outreach@NATA, again, that's NAATANET.org, and ask them how you can bring your students out to that program.
And there you have it. That was Tad Nakamura, writer director of Yellow Brotherhood, which will be playing at Asian American Film Festival this month. That was not Denizen Kane. And you know, we're kind of moving stuff around here. We're kind of pulling our hair out. But you know what? We're gonna keep it moving along. And right now, we actually have the interview with Denizen Kane. And so here we go. We're not tripping, folks. You're at the right place. Apex Express, Asian Pacific Islander Radio, 94.1 KPFA, KPFB in Berkeley, KFCF in Fresno. Your host Kiwi along with Maya, and we are here tonight with acclaimed poet and MC Dennis Kane, straight out of Chicago from the Typical Cats crew. What's up? How you doing, man? Thanks for joining us.
I'm chilling. I can't look at you directly. This whole microphone thing is weird, but
it's all good.
Thank you for having me on your show. I'm really honored to be the first guest on Apex Express.
And we're excited to have you, man. So let's get right into it, bro.
Sure.
Tell us a little bit about yourself and how you got into hip-hop.
How I got into hip-hop. This is always a good question. It's a memory lane type question.
You're from Chicago, right?
From Tree City. Chicago is one of the many places I've stopped off at. There's a lot of places that I feel at home in. You know, Chicago, the Bay, Seattle, L.A. is starting to grow on me. But never really one place that I could call home. And I think that's kind of the burden of our people in this place too, is that when you think of representatives of certain spots and certain regions of the country, we're usually the last face that comes to mind, unless you're talking about a Chinatown or a J-Town, K-Town, you know, a place in a place, you know. And that's kind of what Tree City means to me. It's the right place within the place that folks like us belong, you know. As far as hip-hop, it just, I mean, the streets were just so saturated with it when we were kids, you know. I know you probably feel the same way. People are like, how did you get into hip-hop? You're like, I had ears. I was standing around when the cars
were
by. It was out there, you know. And but once you got bit, once you got the bug, you know, you start digging for it, you know. And sometimes we lived in places where it was just everywhere. You could step out onto your porch and a car would be rolling by and it would be bumping the latest, you know, hot single. And sometimes you really had to dig for it, and you'd be buying the little Rap Masters taped at the Walgreens, and you'd be, you know, in Chicago we watched this show called Master Sellers on Saturdays. I come on WGBO channel 66, and just bootleg local show that had the videos with the real slow fades, and as the video faded out, the background noise would get mad loud,
right.
And, you know, We just loved it. We just kept looking for it whenever it popped up.
And what would you say led to the emceeing?
Man, I think I was always one of those kids that had a big chip on their shoulder just to be seen, you know, just to be heard. And some people, I don't think anybody enjoys being fronted on, but it seems like some people develop a tolerance for it and some people just don't.
Right.
You know what I mean? Like, and I think I was one of the shorties that people be like, you can't do that. I was like, why? You know, why can't I do that? You know, and emceeing, it just seems so powerful. You know, you were talking over music. It felt powerful. You know, people who did it had that high profile. You could, you know, and I identified with that, and I really wanted to do it. And eventually, as I became more aware of self, I felt like I had something more to say than just, you know, blah blah blah, check out what I'm wearing.
Well, how has your spoken word, like in poetry, roots affected you as an MC?
That's a good question too. I really see them working in harmony with each other. And I really, to some people, the issue is really complicated. Like, what's poetry and what's hip hop? I don't know. You know, and to me, it's like one has beats and one doesn't have beats. And I know that's overly simplistic, but it basically what it is to me. Like, I remember being in New York for Deaf Poetry, and they're like, "Oh, special guest Rakim," and people are like, "Oh, snap, it's Rakim." And all he did was he dropped the first verse from the ghetto a cappella, and it was a poem, and it was beautiful, and it was the rawest joint of the whole night. And all these stellar poets were like, "Oh, my joint sucks," you know. And all these things that people look down on rap lyrics for sometimes, "Oh, your stuff rhymes," you know, it's bound by convention and this bar structure. And I'm like, man, this is just a vehicle, just like anything else. And I think there is a power to having your words just have no boundary, and I think that's something that's ill about poetry and spoken word. But I really want to have the ability to do anything I feel, and, like, you know, thrive in any format that I'm put in. You know, that's part of something our people have had to do too. You know, we've had to exist in so many different, you know, corners of the culture, and, you know, be at ease in between these two things, and then in between these two things, you know. So it started, like, if you went to an open mic sometimes they were free, sometimes they let you in the bar even if you were underage. You didn't have to have a beat, you didn't even have to have a, you know, another dude backing you up. You just stood up, said things, you know. It's a good way to just try, you know.
So you are of Korean descent?
Yes, sir.
And oftentimes when people think of hip hop, they think, if they think of hip hop and Koreans, they, or Asians in general, they usually think of, you know, the DJ,
right,
or the dude that, you know, designed the cover for the CD. And but you, on the other hand, are coming with the lyrics, and which, you know, which for a Korean cat is kind of rare, you know. And so do you feel like, you know, do you feel like you're breaking any boundaries, or is this something that you do regardless?
I really do feel like I would do it regardless. I think all of us who look the way we look and are doing the way we're doing what we're doing, at certain points we stop and be like, wow, maybe I was the first to do that. But if I really do think if I was thinking that way every single time I went out to do something, it would get in the way of what I was trying to do, you know. I think there's a lot of cats out there, we just haven't heard them yet, you know what I mean?
Obviously now there's a lot more more sort of diversity in terms of MCs and rap crews and stuff like that. How would you say it's different now compared to when you were first starting and people looked at you as this MC, as this Asian MC? Like, how is it different now?
Oh, man, it's so hard to compare. I don't know if you had the same experience, but did this ever happen to you as, like, a young kid coming up? Like, you would be in a spot and maybe it wouldn't look as, like, diverse, as you say, you know, because now you, right. I feel like you can go to a spot and there'll be Asian kids there. There'll be white, black, Latino, everybody, you know, native, you know. Catch you, you're like, where are you from? I don't even know, you know. But back in the day, we would go to a lot of spots where we were the only people that looked like us, you know. We might go to a spot and it was all white in this North Side poetry venue. You might, right, go to a spot and it's all black in this South Side hip hop venue. But when you bust, people like, oh, and they would, you know, and they would recognize, and that was love, you know. And but it's such a weird time now because the culture, well, the culture has developed, but the industry has developed so much that even though it might be real verse looking, there's a lot of just crab, you know, just crab attitude people there, and you could be the illest, and people be like, oh.
Would you say it's like a catch-22 or something like that?
I definitely don't. I think it would have happened regardless. That's just the world that we live in, so I don't think it's like a trade-off. I think it had to happen because that's what's happening. It's just ironic, I guess, you know, because when we were younger, it was like the biggest obstacle was just somebody giving us a chance, you know.
Mm-hmm.
And sometimes you would have to fight to get the mic, and sometimes you would have to fight just, you know, to be taken seriously. But once you got your foot in, people would be like, oh, I remember you. Even if cats didn't know how to talk to you yet,
right,
you know, oh, it's the Chinese dude, these cats are ill. But it was love. And then, you know, as you built, you know, you learned something about me that you didn't know. I learned something about you that, you know, I didn't know. And it turns out that we have something to build on.
Right.
And nowadays, it's like we are a little more visible. So maybe people have a small category for us in their heads already, which seems like an advantage, but it's just I don't know, man. I guess when you get a certain age, you always miss the innocent days, you know.
Yeah,
it felt a little more innocent back then. I'm not mad, you know.
Right now you are part of a crew called Typical Cats.
Yes
out of Chicago. Y'all put out a album recently entitled Civil Service, and why don't we get into one of these joints right now. Again, this is KPFA 94.1. We are here with Dennis and Kane, and this one is entitled Justice Coming, right here on Apex Express.
Go struggle to see the picture, bigger than you imagine. Stakes as high as red, the meth on gang and blood arrested. Cannot follow procedure, to them or die, son. We live and die, they roll the dice and we comply, son. The rich are in the city, on the hill and chillin'. The poor will fight the wolf and come back to be labor villain. The dog will play the shadow, the pretty ones get fondled. The lazy ones get lied to, the loud get lost and handled. The brilliant ones will disappear, the fearless ones get fired on. The zealots at the last stand, cutting the fire wrong. The immigrant's a stepchild, stranger, a hype man. Slave with the green card, choking on the hyphen. Furious as King George is curious. Notorious regime paying the White House dollar green. A hollow fiend, they claim it mean and crystal Christian. But those who claim it don't honor the name of silly bitches. Die slow.
Images, senators, pharmacists, friends concerned with riches. The lotus is venom and denim brands, plans to handle sickness. Grill advances, bishop demanding his pot to piss in a bottomless pit to dig in if you dig.
That was Justice Coming by Typical Cats, right here on Apex Express. And we are here with one of the members of that crew, MC Poet Denizen Kane. And so right now, we're, as you know, we're living in crazy times. There's a war going on, obviously. There's, you know, U.S. imperialist occupation all over the world. Over here, there's money being taken away from ghouls and from healthcare. You know, youth of color are being criminalized. And, you know, listening to your music, I hear more than just sort of the standard MC braggadocio and battle raps. I also hear about struggle and resistance. Now, what would you say, you know, are a couple major social issues that you talk about in your music, and why would you say they're important?
All right. I like this question. I like where you're going with this. It's really simple for me. Not because the issues are simple, because, like you said, the world is in a crazy, crazy place right now. But I feel like because what I want is so simple that it keeps me focused despite what the talking heads on television might keep saying. You know, I want the cats on top to tell the people the truth, tell the children the truth. Number one, because they lie. They just lie and lie and lie and lie. And I feel like we come from places where there's consequences to lying and there's consequences to not being a man of your word. And it's wild because why aren't they're the same rules for these dudes who run things on top, you know? And basically, you have to let me be a man. You have to let me feed my family. You have to let me take care of my woman and child. You have to let me take care of, you know, my city and my people, you know? And it's like, that's real basic stuff, you know? No matter what political terms you put on it, that's what all of us want. And you're not giving it to us. You're not, you know. And I don't care if you don't give it to me, then at the very least you have to stand aside and let us do it for ourselves. And they're not letting either one happen, so they're not letting either one happen, you know.
I'm curious, you heard a little bit about the Hot 97 stuff, right?
Yeah.
I'm curious about what your thoughts are with that. Like, with that, it's like, you know, like, who would you say is at fault? Like, you know, like, what needs to be done with that situation?
Oh, dog, I can't even call it, man. I mean, it was bogus. I will say that much. It was bogus. And I feel like I'm one of those cats that can really see, like, where you're coming from, you know. And we had a little bit of distance from it because we're not in New York. And right. I heard about it, and cats were telling me, did you hear the joint on Hot 97? It's crazy, man. You know, I'm like, I'm not even trying to hear it because I feel like I'm hearing this bogus. I trust your opinion. I don't want to hear this bogusness. But somebody played it for us at one spot that we were at. I'm like, wow. These cats really went there. They really, really went there. And I know that it's easy sometimes just to make what somebody else is going through small and trivial, you know. And I was really proud. I just spoke to Cutting Candy. I was really proud of what folks like her were doing in New York and making sure that, cats who were in a position to program stuff like that knew that, you know, you can't really do this. You can't really just, use folk as a punchline for a joke and think everything's swell the next morning. It's not really how it works, you know. And I was proud of Jin for saying something. I was proud of, you know, everybody who's come to bat and said, hey, you know, our people aren't going to stand for this. You know, that's really what's up.
So what's next for Denizen Kane?
What's next? Man, we have a Typical Cats joint out that dropped pretty recently. I really don't know if everybody knows that it's out.
What's the name of that one?
It's called Civil Service.
Civil Service.
And I'll be hitting y'all with copies. Have a joint called Tree City Legends Volume 2. That's the follow-up to the EP that we dropped a couple years back, and it's finally coming out. Right. It's, you know, it took a while, but I'm happy that it's dropping. I think we're talking like mid-May, maybe, so folks can look out for that. It'll be on the website,
Galapagos4.com.
And just did a little something for Deaf Poetry Jam. In New York. Someone said hi to Mo, said hi to Russell.
Get some fat farm.
Don't tell anybody I racked the fat farm room, too.
What about shows or tours or anything like that?
Oh, man, well, you know I'm going to be a Puso.
Uh-oh.
Tomorrow.
Tomorrow?
Tomorrow.
Wait a minute.
Come and check it out.
Wait. So what exactly is that, Maya?
Well... It's called Apex Out the Box. Bring it to you live and direct. Denizen Kane out of the Apex KPFA studio and right down the street at Pusod, 1808 Fifth Street, Berkeley. Go to pusod.org/pusod for directions. I hear it's going to be a dope show.
That's what I hear, too.
Yeah.
I got a joint with Native Guns coming out.
Uh-oh.
Y'all look for that.
Hey. Anyway, speaking of joints, we got a joint right now that we're going to close off this session with. Again, this is Apex Express 94.1 KPFA. Kids, turn on your tape recorders right now. This is Denizen Kane.
Everybody gotta look in the mirror, right?
Welcome to the world that God made from verses, loose lines and curses. Roses make dirt, dirt makes roses. The earth makes suns, the suns make corpses. Whole folks say we do too much, but for me, it's never enough. Gotta go within to get to heaven above. Throw your hands up, show me some love. Whole folks say we do too much, but for me, it's never enough. Gotta go within to get to heaven above. Throw your hands up, show me some love. See, I was born for music. Pain introduced me to it. Pop pushed me to it. Said I couldn't do it. I'm all stressed, can't sleep, only half rest. Reminesce, kind of strong, let the treble clef. Push keys, pull strings, pedal back. So, when I move, I can make them all bang notes. Orchestrate scores, orchestrate tours. My compositional skill will decompose yours. Hand skills are sharp, all staccato. Laid loud talkers, flat, shh, piano. Pull the honey so smooth like legato. Beautiful music, she a mezzo soprano. I'm a baritone. My poem changed the tenor of the E. Never leave a bleed from the center of the soul. These songs from the heart flow like a river of liquor through these bars. Whole folks say we do too much, but for me it's never enough. Gotta go within to get to heaven above. Throw your hands up, show me some love. Whole folks say we do too much, but for me it's never enough. Gotta go within to get to heaven above. Throw your hands up, show me some love. Now, welcome to the world that God made from verses, loose lines and curses. Roses make dirt, dirt makes roses. The earth makes suns, the suns make horses. Welcome to the world that God made from verses, loose lines and curses.
roses make dirt, dirt makes roses. The earth makes suns, the suns make corpses. Oh, folks say we do too much, but for me, it's never enough. Gotta go with it to get to heaven above. Throw your hands up, show me some love. Show me some love.
And this is Apex Express. This is G right back here. I just want to say that you've been listening to Dennis and Kane. Also, a renaissance is really happening in music and more in the South Asian community, both here and abroad. So do listen up, because Nishat's with us to talk with a local producer and South Asian DJ. And he's going to be talking about a big event that's coming up right immediately. So let's take a listen.
You're listening to Apex Express. I'm Nishat Kra, and I'm here at 1015 Folsom with Janika Selecta from The Mala Collective. We're going to talk a little bit about an event that The Mala is throwing this Friday, March 4th at 1015 Folsom. People who listen to Apex might be familiar with The Mala's music. Who else are they going to be seeing, and how is it similar or different from what you guys do?
We're actually bringing out as the main headlining act Bobby Friction and Nihal from the UK. They do a very, very popular BBC Radio 1 show on Wednesdays at 9 p.m., which is a mainstream slot. And also Chebi Saba, as well as myself, Janika Selecta, Manish the Twister, DJ Dragonfly, Sep. There's a whole host of people. And we're doing it in a five-room environment. So we have a main room, which features kind of the heavy, hard, bouncy dance music. We have a classical Indian music room, which features Pakistani folk singing from Sukhat Ali Khan and Rifat Sultana. And the Groove Garden features kind of a more chiller atmosphere, but again also on a world music style. And to top it off, Adam Ohana will be throwing a breaks room, which features local breakbeat artists.
That's the voice of Janika Selecta from The Mala Collective. They are, you might know them for the parties they throw at Club 6. Friday, March 4th, they're going to be at 1015 Folsom for Worldly, with 20-plus artists, including Bobby Friction and Nihal from BBC UK. You guys have a pretty good following among Desis in the Bay Area and even outside of the Desi community, people who really enjoy the music. So for a space like this, is there any pressure in terms of filling it up?
No, I mean, there's an enormous amount of pressure in these events, enormous. I mean, you know, this space can hold 2,500 people. I mean, that's difficult anywhere in the world, you know. This particular event that we're throwing, if thrown in London, would be harder probably, because I think that the Bay Area itself is a little more open. The UK has, especially London, has a huge South Asian community, and so they do have inherent support for that particular music. But, you know, these things go in phases, and what's happening in the UK now is still very important, because the music's there, people are producing the music, but I think it's got a much more global scope with things like the internet and stuff. So what you might see at a club event there, it won't necessarily be as big as something like Worldly, because you know, there's no collective or no group of people out there really promoting events of this size by a long shot.
Is there a turning point that you can identify where clubs like a 1015 Folsom started becoming more open to having events like these here, having world music here?
To be very, very honest, I haven't been to 1015 Folsom in the last, I would say, probably 4 or 5 years. And there has been a great big, you know, change, almost a 180, because, you know, the people that work at the club have changed. And so, you know, you get events here like, you know, hardcore drum and bass events, which is not mainstream.
Can you tell folks a little bit about the event?
They can basically get in at 10 o'clock and it closes down at 6 a.m. You know, go to damalsf, www.dhamalsf.com. And you can sign up for a $15 pre-sale list. Otherwise, it's $20 if you come at the door, so it makes sense to sign up. There's a big difference.
Thanks, Janika.
Thank you.
And you've just been listening to Damal, and the music underneath that we're listening to is Karsh Kale, Six Degrees Recording Artist, Karsh Kale. We do have two pairs of tickets to give away for the show Friday night, Worldly, and if you would like the two pairs of tickets, please call here, Apex Express at KPFA, 510-848-4425. That's 510-848-4425. Two pairs of tickets to give away to this great event, and we'll take the 10th callers after 8 p.m., okay, because we got some other tickets to give away as well. The NATA Asian American International Film Festival is starting tonight, and they've got wonderful, wonderful films from all over the Asian diaspora as far as in Asia. If you want more information, please go to their site, www.naatanet.org. That's www.natanet.org. And we do have two pairs of tickets to give away to a film that they're showing, and the film is called Swades, and it is by the director from the Oscar-nominated movie, Lagaan, if folks remember that. It was a big breakout South Asian movie. He has directed a movie about a South Asian engineer who goes back to his home village and sort of the struggles he has about that. Now, if you would like to check this out, it's at the Castro Theater, Friday, March 11th, the Castro Theater, Friday, March 11th, 9:30 p.m. We do have two pairs of tickets to give away. And again, call us after 8 p.m. and we'll take the two callers who call in, the 13th and 14th caller. And that number to call is 510-848-4425, 510-848-4425. And I want to bring all the mics back on. So, you know, we got a little bit of time here, too. I was just talking so fast. There's two times here. I see one time here and one time there. Well, that's a KPFA thing, you know. So we're going to kind of compromise here. I do want to say thank you. My name is G. Curtis has been great on the board. I want to say Pusod, come out and check it out tomorrow night. Pusod is right down on 5th Street in West Berkeley, right by the freeway, right on University. And I want to say thank you to Maya. Maybe you can give the number out one
thank
more time
you.
For Pusod.
It's www.pusod.org/pusod, and the number is 510-883-1808.
And I'll let Kiwi have the last words for tonight's show.
Well, first of all, I just wanted to thank Jenna, Curtis on the board, and the rest of the Apex crew, as well as KPFA, for allowing us to do this. And, you know, we're really, really excited about, you know, the possibilities that a program like this holds, especially in regards to representing the Asian Pacific Islander youth voice. And, you know, of course, I wouldn't be here if it wasn't for Maya over here from Pusod, you know, giving me that first holla. So, again, just thank you. And
I just want to say one other thing, too. I do think that, folks, if you like the show or if you have any comments, please give Apex a call, 510-848-6767, extension 464, or you can go to www.kpfa.org. And again, this is KPFA and KPFB in Berkeley and KFCF in Fresno. And with that, I do want to say thank you all here.
Thank you. Thank give you. Us a shout, you know.
Yep.
This is for you.
Pusod tomorrow.
Okay.
Tomorrow,
and we will be here every Thursday. And I want to check out and say stay tuned for Bonnie Simmons.